Highlighted in green here, we can see the quadriceps muscle group, which is also commonly referred to as the quads. It's a group of four large muscles located on the front of the thigh. The most medial quadricep muscle is the vastus medialis, and its distal fibers here are commonly referred to as the vastus medialis oblique, or VMO for short. The most lateral quadricep muscle is called the vastus lateralis, and it's the largest and most powerful muscle in the quadriceps muscle group. It's also located right next to the iliotibial band here. If you'd like to learn more about the iliotibial band, I've got a video on that as well. Located in the middle here, we have the rectus femoris muscle, and this is a special muscle in the quadriceps muscle group because it's the only quadriceps muscle that's biarticular, and biarticular means it's crossing two joints, so it's crossing both the knee joint and the hip joint as well. And this is important because it allows it to have actions at both of these joints, whereas the other quadriceps muscles are only going to have actions at the knee joint. Our last quadriceps muscle is the vastus intermedius, and we can't see it in this picture here because the vastus intermedius is deep to the rectus femoris, so the rectus femoris is covering up the vastus intermedius muscle. Let's take a look at the origins next, and we'll start by looking at the rectus femoris muscle. So you can see the rectus femoris muscle coming up here, and it connects at two places because it has two heads of origin. So the first head here is called the direct head, and the next head of the rectus femoris, that's called the indirect head. The direct head originates from the anterior aspect of the inferior iliac spine. So this bony prominence right here, this would be the anterior inferior iliac spine. And then this bony prominence up here, this would be the anterior superior iliac spine. The indirect head originates from the acetabular ridge, and the acetabular ridge is essentially this ridge that runs around the acetabulum here, and the acetabulum is this socket which the head of the femur sits inside of. Moving on to the vastus lateralis origins next, you can see the origins on the anterior of the femur here highlighted in red. These origins wrap around the femur to the posterior of it as well, so it's originating from both the front and the back of the femur, and we'll start by going over the origins on the front of the femur first. The first origin point is going to be on the greater trochanter of the femur, which is this bony prominence just at the proximal end and on the lateral side. So proximal would be to the top of the femur and lateral would be the outside. Now another bony landmark on the femur is the lesser trochanter, which is this smaller bony prominence here. And between the greater and the lesser trochanter, there's a ridge that runs just around where I'm moving my cursor here. And you'll notice the ridge is on this red section of the origin, which I've got marked out. So that means that the intertrochanteric line is also another origin point of the vastus lateralis muscle. Moving over to the posterior of the femur, this red line is a continuation of those other origin points which we've just seen before. So it wraps around from the anterior of the femur and then continues onto the posterior of the femur here. Our first origin point is going to be the gluteal tuberosity, which is a roughened area just here where I'm moving my cursor at the moment. As the origin continues downwards, it's then going to originate from the linea aspera. The linea aspera is a ridge that runs down the back of the femur here. So where I'm moving my cursor at the moment, there's a ridge right here, and that would be the linea aspera. In addition to those two origin points, it's also originating from the lateral intramuscular septum of the thigh. And that's a deep fold of fascia which separates the anterior and posterior compartments of the thigh. So essentially this fascia divides the vastus lateralis and the biceps femoris muscles from each other. So the biceps femoris is one of the hamstring muscles, and between the biceps femoris and the vastus lateralis, there's a fold of deep fascia, and that fascia is called the lateral intramuscular septum of the thigh, and the vastus lateralis is connecting onto that fascia as one of its origin points. So let's take a look at the vastus medialis origin points next, and much like the vastus lateralis which we just looked at, the vastus medialis' origin points are going to start on the anterior of the femur and then continue down all the way onto the posterior of the femur. Our first origin point is going to be on the inferior part of the intertrochanteric line. You remember we discussed that in the lateralis section just before, and it's a ridge that runs down here, connecting the greater trochanter and the lesser trochanter. In addition to the intertrochanteric line, it's also originating from the pectineal line, which is another ridge in this area here. The pectineal line is also referred to as the spiral line. Swapping over to a posterior view again now, you can see the continuation of that origin point running down the back of the femur here. And our first bony landmark is going to be the linea aspera again, which you remember is a ridge that runs down the back of the femur here, and is going to be on the medial part of the linea aspera, so the medial side of the ridge, which would be the section of the ridge that's closest to the midline of the body here. So as it runs down the linea aspera, it then splits off onto the medial supracondylar line. So the linea aspera gets to around here, and then it splits off into two other ridges that go more towards the lateral and the medial side of the femur. So the split on this side would be the medial supracondylar line, and then when it splits off to the lateral side, that would be the lateral supracondylar line. Our next origin point is going to be the medial intramuscular septum. And much like the lateral intramuscular septum we discussed earlier, this is a deep fascia layer of the thigh, and in this case it separates the medial and anterior compartments of the thigh, and it's also serving as another origin point for the vastus medialis muscle. Our last two origin points are going to be the adductor longus and the adductor magnus muscles. Both these muscles are part of the adductor group of muscles, and they're located in the medial compartment of the thigh. Our last quadriceps muscle is the vastus intermedius muscle, and its origins are on the upper two thirds of the anterior and the lateral surface of the femur. So the anterior surface would be the front of the femur, and the lateral surface would be the outside of the femur. In addition to connecting onto the femur itself, it's also originating from the lateral intramuscular septum of the thigh, which you'll remember from before is a sheet of deep fascia that separates the anterior and the posterior compartments of the thigh. So let's look at the insertion of the quadriceps muscle group next. All of the quadriceps muscles are going to merge together and form the quadriceps tendon. The quadriceps tendon then inserts onto the patella and the patellar ligament. So the quadriceps tendon will be coming down here, and then it connects onto the patellar ligament right here. The patellar ligament then continues down the leg, crosses the knee joint, and eventually connects onto the tibial tuberosity. The tibial tuberosity is a bony protrusion on the front of the tibia, and for clarity, I've marked the tibial tuberosity in blue here on the other leg. The quadriceps muscle group is innervated by the femoral nerve. This nerve is a major branch of the lumbar plexus, and you can see the lumbar plexus on the right hand side of the screen here. The femoral nerve originates from the ventral rami of spinal nerves L2, L3 and L4. The femoral nerve is one of the main nerves which supplies motory and sensory innervation to the muscles of the anterior compartment of the thigh, including the quadriceps muscles. So let's take a look at the actions next. So all of the quadriceps muscles converge to form the quadriceps tendon, and this tendon connects onto the patella and the patellar ligament, and the patellar ligament crosses the knee joint and connects onto the tibial tuberosity. So as the quadriceps contract, they're going to pull on the patellar ligament, which is then going to pull on the tibial tuberosity and cause extension of the knee joint. So we've got extension of the knee joint as our first and primary action of the quadriceps muscle group. In addition to this, they're also able to stabilize the knee joint as well. So for example, we've got the vastus medialis on the inside here, which has more of a medial line of pull, and the vastus lateralis on the outside here, that has more of a lateral line of pull. And we've got the intermedius and the rectus femoris in the middle here, and all of them can work together to stabilize this knee joint. In addition to stabilizing the knee joint, the rectus femoris crosses the hip joint. So only the rectus femoris has actions at the hip joint, and the rectus femoris contributes to flexion of the hip joint. So flexion of the hip joint is another action of the quadriceps muscle group, but it's only the rectus femoris that contributes to that action. So if you've enjoyed the video or you found it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press that like, subscribe, let me know what you thought of the video in the comment. It really helps out the channel. Thanks again for watching, everyone. I'll see you all next time.